My name is Toria Fischer, and I'm a senior undergraduate student here in the Pearson Lab at the University of Kentucky. And in this lab, we study the effects of maternal interventions during pregnancy on the health of offspring. I am from Hebron, Kentucky, in northern Kentucky, and kind of always been in love with science my entire life. So in high school, I started really finding a passion for biology and chemistry. So when I went to college, I knew that I wanted to study something with that. I didn't know exactly what I wanted to do, but I chose an awesome major here at UK, agricultural biotechnology, that kind of allows me to dip into a little bit of research and a little bit of clinical medicine, and then I finally decided that I wanted to pursue medical school. So my dad comes from a science background, and my mom is actually a math teacher. So I grew up in the summertime doing, you know, math notebooks over the summer, little work problems that my mom would set up for me. So that's kind of when I fell in love with math. And then when I got to high school is when I really started to develop my love for science. So my everyday in the lab, I kind of work in collaboration with one of the graduate students here. So we work kind of together as a team to kind of just work on whatever projects need to be done at that point in time. So when I completed my research project, I did a lot of things in the lab on my own, whereas now I'm working more in a team environment, and by doing so, we really developed this great culture here in the lab. And in addition to that, we like to share our research with other people outside the university. So after I completed my research project, I shared my findings at the National Conference of Undergraduate Research that we had here at UK. So they always have great opportunities for us to kind of show our research, to show other people what we're doing. So I do a lot of work with quantitative PCR, and PCR is polymerase chain reaction, and it is a way for us in the lab to look at differences in gene expression. So differences in DNA expression to DNA sequences, different amounts of DNA that different samples show. So I work a lot with creating plates for these PCR reactions. So, and the ultimate goal at the end is to look at differences in gene expression between different treatment groups that we have in the lab. I actually just found out a few months ago that I'm going to be attending medical school here at the University of Kentucky, so I'm really, really excited about that. But I hope to take my research experience, what I've learned in the lab, with me once I become a practicing clinician. So, you know, today's medicine really is kind of centered around pharmacological ways to treat disease with drugs, but there's also several other ways that you can treat disease with things like nutrition and exercise, like things that we're learning what the effects are doing in our lab. So that's something that I hope to take with me when I become a practicing doctor, to show that, you know, there are different ways to treat disease just besides drugs. So my advice for students that are really interested in following this research path is to start early. Because when you start early, I find that you have a lot more opportunities. So instead of jumping into things your senior year, and maybe you thought you were going to follow this route, this career path, maybe you get into research your senior year and absolutely fall in love with it and you want to completely switch your path. So if you start early, it gives you that time, but it also gives you the time to really develop a passion. If you're here in the lab for several years, you become acquainted with things in the lab. And I know at the beginning for me, there was such a learning curve, but once I've been in the lab for several years, I absolutely love it. And it's one of my favorite things to come to work every day.